Hi, today's tutorial is going to be on how to retouch a photograph in iPhoto quickly and easily. So the first thing that we're going to do is have to open up iPhoto, and as you can see I have mine open here, and we're going to select the photo that we'd like to retouch. So I'm going to pick this picture over here, which is of a lake with some trees in the background. It's a nice picture, but it really doesn't have the color that I would like to see. So in order to kind of fix that, I'm going to come down here to the Edit menu, and I'm going to click on that Edit menu. First thing I can do here is I have three tabs. I have Quick Fixes, Effects, and Adjust. In Quick Fixes, I can rotate the image by clicking on it until I have it exactly the way I want, so that's a quick way to fix it. I can click on Auto Enhance, which enhances the color immediately, which already it's looking a lot better. I could fix red eye, but obviously I don't need it here because I don't have any people who have red eyes in the picture, so I'll skip that one. I could straighten the image, basically allowing me, let's say, to create the horizon line to be straight. And as you can see, there we go. Hit done when you're completed. I can also crop the image, so if I don't really want the entire image, I only want a small piece of it, I can come in and drag it any way I would like. So let's say I just want that part of the image, and I would hit done, and that would actually crop it. Be careful about that, because once you crop it, you are done. Another thing that is here is retouching. So you can make the circle as big or as small as you'd like. So let's do a big one here. And let's say I just don't like the way this shadow is here. I'm going to drag my mouse as I'm clicking, let go, and as you can see, it did some retouching of it. But it's not really what looks good with this picture, so I'm going to undo it. It's mainly used to clean up a blemish on your skin. If up here, for example, the clouds, I'll show you on that what it would do. You see, I got rid of the blue in it, but I kind of want the blue, so I'm going to put it back. But that's how you can use the retouching tool. When you complete it, hit done. Now let's go to effects. So effects, you can do different things. You can click sepia, you can do antique, you can do an edge blur, which does it on the side. You can do a vignette, a matte, a fade, a boost of color. And of course none, which is back to the way we were. So if there is something in here that you like, you can pick it. You can also click on cooler, and each time you click on it, you'll see I'm getting more blues. You can darken the image if you want, or you can lighten the image if you want. And I think it definitely needs to be lightened a bit. You can increase the saturation, and then you can increase the contrast, and then you can increase the saturation. And look at the difference of this picture when I'm simply doing that. If you find that you want to go warmer, you can do that too and give it a more warmer look. But look at where we started and look at where we are now. It's just wonderful, and the colors are popping and they're vibrant. If we go to adjust, which is the last one, these levels adjust the lightness and the darkness. So if you have an overexposed image, you can, a dark image would be dark and this would be light. You can lighten up the image a bit, and I kind of like it somewhere about here. You can increase the contrast and kind of play around with that so you can see how that contrast works. The saturation, you could put even more saturation in and give it even more popping color. You can add some definition, which is another thing. Highlights, you can add that as well. You can see really what's going on with the clouds up there. They're really taking on a very surreal effect. So you may like that, you may not, but you basically can see how the shadows, and this is the sharpness, how each of these, the noise will actually give it a blur. And the last one here is color temperature, so you can go with a blue effect or you can go with a little bit more green. So you can play around with that, and this is also on the tints. So at this point, if you don't like what you did here, you can always click undo, and it will undo everything that you pretty much did. So that works out nicely. Once you're done with everything, you do have the option to revert to the original. So if you don't like everything that you retouched and you want to start again, you can just revert to the original, and that's what we originally started with. Once you do that, you can no longer do an undo. So be careful if that's what you wanted. So just a quick recap, if you want to do this really fast, you can click Enhance, go into Effects, do some saturation here, which is what I was doing, go a little cooler, go a little lighter, and you already have a better picture. Go to adjust, do your final adjustments right here. Change the exposure slightly. And once you're done, all you would have to do is click on Photos here, and the final retouched image will be saved. And as you can see, here we have the retouched image, which has a very different look than the original one. Well, I hope you've gotten some good tips on how to retouch pictures. I'll try to do some more on these in the future so that you can get some quick tips on how to get your photos looking amazing. Thanks for listening, and enjoy retouching your pictures.